morning, everyone. Good morning to everyone, especially who's watching online. I'm David Cook, and I have the honour of First Citizen and Lord Mayor of Newcastle upon Tyne to lead this very special ceremony today. There are only a few of us here at the World War II Memorial in Old Eldon Square to mark the 75th anniversary of VE Day. It's a very different occasion to that we had anticipated due to the coronavirus pandemic, which has impacted all our lives. There are, however, a number of contributions on a City Council Facebook page, VE Day 75 Newcastle. However, it's fitting that the city marks this momentous day as a real event, and I'm joined by the Leader of Council, Nick Forbes, the Bishop of Newcastle, the Right Reverend Christine Hardman, and from the 5th Regiment of Fusiliers, Commanding Officer Lieutenant Colonel Steve Burton and Staff Sergeant Richard Stacey from the Fusilier Band. Strict social distancing measures will be observed throughout this short event. I'll ask Councillor Forbes to give an address. Bishop Christine will offer a prayer and Lieutenant Colonel Burton will recite the epitaph before the last post is played by Staff Sergeant Stacey, followed by a 2 minute silence. And to conclude, I will lay a wreath on behalf of the City Council and the people of Newcastle. I'd like to say a few words about this specific wreath. Many of you will remember that to mark the 100th anniversary of the end of the First World War in 2018, residents of the city very kindly donated many thousands of knitted poppies to decorate the war memorial and the whole of Eldon Square. Now, a member of council staff has used some of those poppies to make this wreath for today in the rather charming make-do and mend tradition of World War II. And in this simple way, we are including residents from across the city who participated in that project but cannot be here today with us in person. So, Councillor Forbes.
Thank you, Lord Mayor, and welcome to all of the guests joining us here today. Bishop Hardman, Lord Mayor, Lady Mayoress, representatives from the Fusiliers. Welcome also to all of you joining us digitally as we broadcast this short ceremony online. As the Lord Mayor has already said, we will be finished in time to observe the national 2 minute silence at 11 a.m. And I would encourage you, wherever you are, join us in a few moments of reflection. We come together as a city to remember the incredible sacrifices made across the globe during the Second World War, to pay respect to those who lost their lives during the conflict, and to renew our commitment to achieving peace and solidarity for all humankind. 75 years ago today, Sir Winston Churchill, the Prime Minister, announced the end of the war in Europe. An end to the suffering, violence, and brutal conflict that had torn countries and communities apart, devastated families, and cost so many lives. The words of Churchill, broadcast from Number 10 Downing Street, still resonate today as the world faces new challenges and battles, when he said, "We may allow ourselves a brief period of rejoicing, but let us not forget for a moment the toils and efforts that lie ahead." On the same day, here in Newcastle, our Lord Mayor at the time stood in St. Nicholas's Square outside the cathedral and read the proclamation that war in Europe was over. This led to some celebrations. Bonfires were lit, ash flickered in the night sky, and buildings were floodlit for the first time. Beacons of hope for the future, lights out of the darkness. Because Newcastle did not escape the fog of war. Many thousands from our city served in the armed forces. Families were torn apart as sons, fathers, uncles, and brothers went to fight for their country, but never returned. Each one of those sacrifices leave a legacy of bravery, unwavering spirit, and valor that we remember today. But the war was fought here too. Our city was regularly bombarded from the air, our strong shipbuilding industries becoming a target for the Blitz. Then, as now, our city's spirit shone through. People risked their lives to continue to build the ships, engines, tanks, and munition, and mine the coal that were all vital to the war effort. Hundreds were killed by falling bombs, thousands of homes reduced to rubble, and more than 40,000 of our city's children were separated from their loved ones and sent away for safety. I know that the last 6 weeks in Newcastle have felt difficult for most of our current residents, but we have to view this in the context of the 6 years of hardship endured by the population here of the time. That's why, as the end of the war was announced, there was no great feeling of celebration, just a sense of weariness at the work to be done at rebuilding Britain. My grandfather, Duncan Forbes, served in the army and fought in Africa, Italy, and Germany. Like many who survived the war, he didn't speak much of his experiences. It wasn't until his funeral that I found out that he'd been awarded the Military Cross for bravery. On this day, 75 years ago, he wrote a letter to his grandmother with his thoughts as conflict came to an end. I'd like to quote some of his letter. He wrote, "I don't know how I ought to feel. As far as we're concerned, this is, of course, no holiday. The usual routine goes on. There's a lot of work to be done. Nobody seems to be particularly excited. I cannot be absolutely certain that here and there is still not fighting in progress, some desperados dying for the fatherland, or some pockets that have no contact with the news of surrender and have not yet received the order to do so. The war in Europe has spluttered to a murky conclusion. There is still a vast area, bigger than all Europe put together, to be liberated in the Far East. That is a thought that hangs like a dark shadow behind any rejoicing. Darker still is the fear, not unreasonable, of failure at San Francisco. Will civilization plunge to a complete ruin? Or will there be a stop to all this rushing downwards? One feels, after these last 6 years, man is capable of any folly. I find it difficult not to feel that rejoicing at the end of this war is part of that folly, that general blindness. We have finished part of a pleasant job. We have cleared away a lot of the filth. Why celebrate? Let us turn away with thanks. Let us hope we have not been polluted ourselves in the process." My grandfather's words, "Man is capable of any folly," and Churchill's, "Let us not forget the toils and efforts that lie ahead," remain incredibly poignant given the battles we face today. The coronavirus pandemic is a different war. The enemy is hidden. The soldiers have been replaced on the front line by nurses, doctors, carers, social workers. Yet families are still being torn apart, tragedy impacting every corner of our city, communities shaken to their core. But I've had every confidence in the grit, determination, and spirit of our city and our ability to overcome anything. We stepped out of the shadow of war to become the vibrant, bustling, modern city we all know and love today. And in the coming weeks, months, and years, we will need to pull together to do this again. Bishop Christie.
Trusting the promises of God, and with faith in his mercy, let us pray. And so we give thanks for the selfless and courageous service and sacrifice of those who brought peace to Europe. We pray for those who died in the violence of that war, each one remembered by and known to God. We pray especially today for veterans of World War II, especially those who will be doing their remembering alone. May they know your peace and your love. We pray for nations still devastated by war and for those who suffer the effects or memories of past wars, those who mourn, for all innocent victims whose lives have been shattered by the cruelty of others. Let us give thanks for those who work for peace, for liberty, for reconciliation throughout the world, and for all who strive to bring an end to injustice and oppression. O Lord our God, as we remember, teach us the ways of peace. As we treasure memories, teach us to hope. As we give thanks for the sacrifices of the past, help us to make your future in this world until your kingdom come. Amen.
They shall grow not old, as we that are left grow old. Age shall not weary them, nor the years condemn. At the going down of the sun, and in the morning, we will remember them. Ha 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 ha
Ha ha ha.